the rush we experience before it gets dark, trying to reach school, getting things done, passing exams, thinking about meals, all the struggles we go through throughout the day, actually remind me of how much a part of nature we are. Of course, there are no such struggles in nature. But life is like that, similar to a triceratops not missing the first light of the morning to satisfy its hunger, but also staying alert against T-Rexes at any moment. Because there is no weekend in nature. We, understanding the value of life, try to shape our lives accordingly. Even though we may not succeed sometimes. Take dinosaurs, for example. If we were to go back to the time they lived and tell them, look, you will be very popular millions of years later, they probably wouldn't believe us. I don't think even Einstein would be remembered this much. However, they wouldn't believe that an asteroid falling from the sky would dig up their roots, because they were not intelligent beings like us. Moreover, we've seen this movie before. However, as highlighted in that film, some of us still think like dinosaurs. The idea that an asteroid wiped out the dinosaurs seems to suggest that. However, the details of this have begun to emerge with some recently published scientific studies. In fact, the concept that an asteroid was the culprit behind the extinction of dinosaurs surfaced in the 80s when we had no knowledge of a crater. Such a massive extinction could only be explained by such a colossal disaster. However, it should have left a crater behind. A trace. Yet, no one knew about such a huge crater. Did the asteroid explode in the sky? Or did thousands of smaller ones fall everywhere? Perhaps a virus caused the extinction and spread everywhere through air currents. But then, we found that crater. Here is that crater. By the way, when you search it on Google, an asteroid slides down, and then the screen shakes. Those interested can try it. This colossal impact crater located on the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico brought about the end of the dinosaurs. However, not all dinosaurs disappeared as a result of such an asteroid collision. Some managed to survive. Were they merely the lucky ones in the race for life, or did they have an advantage? Could nature have prepared them in advance for a disaster of a type they had never experienced? How did the survivors manage to stay alive? Let's first look at what we know about this. 66 million years ago, an asteroid larger than Mount Everest collided with Earth. We know this. The impact was so intense that an energy equivalent to billions of nuclear bombs was released in an instant. The sky was so bright that the sun appeared dim in comparison. The temperature produced was shining like a fireball in the sky. It was impossible to see anything. In a very short time, they felt an increasing heat on their skins. Then, everything within a radius of 1,500 kilometers was incinerated due to this radiation. The shockwave, spreading at the speed of sound, hadn't even reached them yet. This collision, which created a crater with a depth of 25 kilometers and a width of 100 kilometers, was so violent that the reaction force created by the Earth's compressed crust formed a mountain 10 kilometers high. On the other hand, some pieces ejected from the broken crust shot into space at tremendous speeds, and some continued to rain down from the sky onto various regions of Earth. The intensity of the impact was felt even from the other end of the Earth and caused earthquakes up to a magnitude of 11. While the shockwave shattered everything in its path, tsunami waves reaching a kilometer began to spread, clearing everything in their path. A dust cloud, thousands of kilometers in size, spread across the entire Earth, continuing to spread. This collision almost wiped out all the dinosaurs. For example, this chicken did not go extinct. Well, of course, its ancestors were not chickens back then. But because their ancestors survived, today we have this chicken. And it occupies a quite significant place in the lives of many of us. However, two-thirds of life on Earth disappeared. This was not the first, second, or third mass extinction for Earth, it was the fifth. If these species had not gone extinct, Perhaps today we would be acquainted with entirely different organisms. Or maybe we wouldn't exist at all. So, how did the few species that managed to survive pull it off? To understand this, we need to go back to those times, not just by narrating, but by having something from those moments. This is the Tanis fossil site, located in the state of North Dakota in the United States, about 3,000 kilometers away from the impact point. Numerous dinosaur fossils have been excavated from here, not just a dinosaur graveyard. Some remnants here are also believed to have been preserved exactly from that moment of impact. And, of course, for experts, this holds special significance. The asteroid idea, proposed in the 1980s, is generally accepted. In fact, these are the individuals who put forward this idea. The person on the left is Luis Walter Alvarez, who also has a Nobel Prize in Physics. On the right is his son, Walter. Since these two individuals proposed the asteroid idea, there have been some developments. Most people probably agreed with this idea, but it needed further elaboration. Could the dust scattered from the collision have covered the Earth for an extended period, preventing plants from photosynthesizing due to the lack of sunlight and causing them to die? In that case, creatures that fed on plants would also disappear, along with the predators that hunted them. When the lower tier of the food chain vanished, the others should have gradually disappeared as well. It makes sense when you think about it. But this is just an idea, just a thought. We need evidence. First and foremost, how long can these dust particles remain in the atmosphere before falling to the ground? For example, if they are heavy and large enough to clear the sky within a few days, it may not be a very explanatory idea. Many plants could survive this because of it. However, if it stays in the sky for months or years, it could be a very plausible explanation. So, how can we find this dust? Think about it. Yes, you guessed it right, from the Tanis fossil site. Recent studies conducted here shed light on the mystery of this extinction. Not only that, but they also draw attention to another detail, that sulfur might be a reason, not just the dust. Because due to its size, the dust may not stay in the atmosphere long enough. Imagine, on one side, all these effects bringing intense storms and rains. Therefore, dust that can cover the sky for an extended period must be a special kind of dust. And in this field, those sought-after particles have been identified. These dust particles, ranging from approximately 0.8 to 8 micrometers in size, are thought to have covered the sky for 15 years, causing a catastrophic collapse. The analysis showed that the material scattered from the asteroid into the sky was 75% dust, 24% sulfur, and 1% soot. Of course, while these help us understand the process better, there are still many questions to be answered. This is not the first nor the last disaster to happen to this world. Consider all the living beings that have ever existed on this planet until now. 99% of them have gone extinct. And the very small fraction of less than 1% that has been successful is making this video today. What happened that made them successful? Some birds survived because they could fly, and for such a catastrophe, that was a significant advantage. Unfortunately, we don't have wings. But we can still fly because we have this. It's something that allows you to fly and sink. It saves you from mass extinction, but it can also lead you to mass extinction. If we are so curious about dinosaurs, the past, and history today, it's because we can appreciate the value of life. The information we acquire from many different species today extends our lifespan, improves its quality, and allows us to save other species. When we use it correctly, we give life to life. Destruction, on the other hand, only takes us back to the beginning.